There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye. And it feels like it's climbing clear up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. All the cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their heads as they see me ride by. And a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a beautiful feeling.
Hi, Ellen.
Scared of you, Dick. What are you doing right here?
Come sing to you.
All the sounds of the earth are like music. All the sounds of the earth are like music. The breeze is so busy, it won't miss a tree. At me. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
No, you wouldn't, because I would marry you near none of your kinfolks if I could help it.
None of my kinfolks, huh?
Yeah, and you can tell all of that, especially that niece of yours, Miss Lower Williams. Hey, Aunt Ellen, I would have asked you where Lower's at. Where would you say she's at?
I wouldn't tell you at all, for as far as I can make out, Lower ain't paying you no heed.
So she don't take me for too much, huh? Where'd you get such an ugly niece like that wouldn't pay no heed to me? Who's the best drama buster in this year's territory?
You, I bet.
And the best bulldog in the 17 counties? Uh-huh. Me, that's who. And look at you, I'm handsome, ain't I?
Pretty as a picture.
Curly headed, ain't I? And bow-legged from the saddle for God knows how long, ain't I?
Couldn't stop a pig in the road.
Someone could she possibly want, the damn she knew?
I don't know, but I'm sure certainly it ain't you. Who are you taking to the boss social tonight?
Ain't thought much about it.
Then you come over to ask Lori.
And what if I did?
You asked me to? I'll wear my fascinator.
You too.
Can't say I was going with you. Besides, how'd you take me? It ain't like thought you got a new buggy with red wheels on, have you?
No.
Or a spanking team with their bras all jiggling?
Why?
Speaking of how well done it is, you better cross that old common before you touch a shine silver across the river.
If I were to ask you, there'd sure be a way to take you, Miss Lower Smarty.
Oh, they would.
Let my take you out tonight with me. Honey, here's the way it's gonna be. You will set me behind a team of snow white horses in the sleekest thing you've ever seen. Chicks and puffs and geese better scurry when I take you out to Missouri. When I take you out to Missouri with a fringe on top. Watch that fringe and see how it flutters when I step them, I step the shutters. Rosy ghosts will creep through the shutters and their eyes will bow. The wheels are yellow, the upholstery is brown. The passport genuine leather. We're passing our scarves, you can roll right down. In case there's a change in the weather. Two bright sidelights winking and winking. Ain't no higher ring on the thinking. You can keep your ring if you're thinking that I'm here to swap. For that shiny little shirt with the fringe on the top. Wouldn't have no other kind of silk.
Has it really got into a snow-white horses?
One's like snow, the other's more like milk.
So you can't get apart.
For the world will fly in a flurry when I take you out to Missouri. When I take you out to Missouri with a fringe on top. When we hit that road of leather, cats and dogs will dance in the heather, birds and frogs will sing all together, and the tolls will blow. The wind will whistle as you rattle along, the cows will moo in the clover, the river will ripple out a whispered song, and whisper it over and over. Won't you wish it go on forever? Won't you wish it go on forever? Don't you wish it go on forever and never stop? For that shiny lizard with the fringe on the top.
You sure feel like a queen sitting up in a carriage like that.
If only she wasn't so mean to me a while back. I'm a good man not to take her.
You said I was quick.
Ain't that she?
Where'd you even get a rig like that anyway? Oh, I bet he's going to be a little animal and hire one. Taking a cool with him.
So you know all about it?
Spent all this money hiring a rig and now I know nobody riding it.
Make up a few queries and I guess no lot I haven't done them. Don't you really wish there was such a rig though? When you go to the play party, you would go down to mom if he was mad too. And then when he was all worn out, I lived too long to the syrup. Give up a long saddle, and we just point the horses home. I just picture the whole thing. I can see the stars getting blurry when we're by Black Wall in the Surrey. Driving slowly home in the Surrey with a fringe on top. I can feel the day getting colder, feel a sleepy head near my shoulder. Nodding, drooping close to my shoulder till it falls above. The sun is streaming on the rim of a hill. Moon is taking a heather. And just as when I'm feeling all the earth is still, a lovely clock in your manner. Wish you could, my babies are sleeping. Maybe not a dream that they're keeping. Oh, you team, and just keep a creeping at a small flip clock. Don't you worry with the Surrey with the fringe.
will be able to open up yourself.
Well,
why don't you come around here telling me lies? Get me all worked up that way. Talk about some suds running on the hill like it was soap. Who wanna run alongside you anyway?
Why don't you just grab her and kiss her when she acts that way, Curly? She's just aching for you too, I bet.
I wouldn't talk to him, let alone let him kiss me. The bow-legged, bragging, wishy had a sweetheart bum!
She likes you.
If she laughs anymore, she'll stick the dolls out to me.
You get the wagon hitch up?
Wool wagon.
Oh, there's a crowd of folks coming from the bushy heads to go to the box soda.
Curtis said, maybe you loaned us your big wagon to bring it from the station.
Of course I would, if
you'd
ask me.
We got to talking about a lot of other things. I'm going to hitch horses up now for that.
How will?
Oh, Miller.
You do any good at the steer open?
I did pretty good. I won it.
Woo!
Good boy!
I always knew you would.
Ain't nobody can sing a rope like our territory boy.
I can't sing but a minute, Aunt Ellen. Gotta get over to A.O. Amy's house. Don't you remember her positive? I was ever worth $50 I could have her.
$50? That's what they gave you for prize money?
That's what.
Lands. If A.O. Amy's pa keeps his promise, we'll be dancing at your wedding.
And if you don't keep his promise, I'll just take her from under his nose. And I won't be able to get that rope for him. Look, what I have over here. Excuse us, Aunt Ellen. You hold up your eye like this. Then when you get a good look, you turn it around the top and the picture changes. What's happening? They call it the little wonder.
Silly goats. Oh! The hussy ought to be ashamed of herself. You too. How do you, change the thing to see the other picture? Wait, hold up, I'm getting it. I'm a good boy to tell Ada Wang on your...
Oh, please don't, Aunt Ella, she wouldn't understand.
Oh, no telling what you've been up to. Bet you carried on plenty in Kansas City.
I wouldn't call it carrying on. But I sure did see some things that I have never seen before. I got to Kansas City on Friday. By Saturday, I learned a thing or two. For up to then, I didn't have an ID. But this larger world was coming through. I counted 20 gas buckets going by the steps. Almost every time I took a walk. Then I put my ear to a bell telephone. And a strange woman started in to talk.
What next?
Yeah, what next? Everything up to date in Kansas City. They got about as far as they can go. They went and built a skyscraper 7 stories high. About as high as a building more to go. Everything's like a dream in Kansas City. It's better than our magic lantern. You can turn the radiator on whenever you want some heat. With every kind of comfort, every house is all complete. You can walk to Pretty's in the rain and never wet your feet. As you can see, a charity show. One of the gals was fat and pink and pretty, as round above as she was round below. I could swear that she was padded from her shoulder to her heel. But later in the second act, when she began to peel, she proved that everything she had was absolutely real. She went as far as she could go. Yes, sir, she went.
Yeah.
Seems all hit.
Whoa, Curly, can't stop to talk. I gotta get over to 80 Andy's house. I got $50.
Time to get going too, boys. Get to the loan, Aller.
Thank you, Aller.
You coming too, Curly?
I'll catch up with you. Hey, another. I gotta know something. Who's that loafer with the sneak loafer's got a cash set for?
You.
Never mind, man. There must be plenty of men trying to spark her. Ain't sure she's falling for one of them, hasn't she?
Well, there's that fine farmer, Jake Cookies, that lives on the side of Lone Ellum. Then, of course, there's an old weeder man over at Grandma's. Makes out he's a doctor or a veterinarian.
That's what I thought. Hello, Judd.
Hello yourself.
And then, of course, there's someone near her home that's out her eyes mine most of the time so he don't know how to plow from a thrashing machine.
Him?
Yes, Judd Fry.
That Harvey girl name?
Now, I know you don't say nothing again, him. He's the best hired hand I ever had. Just about runs the farm by himself. Well, two women can do it any water than that.
But, Lord, you take up a man like that?
Well, I ain't said she took up with him.
Well, he's here all the time, ain't he? This year?
Out in the smokehouse.
She's going on about throwing out the in-house tonight. I quit early because I'm driving lower after the dance.
You're driving lower.
Well, I asked her.
Wouldn't that make you bald? Don't forget it, Ellie. We got a date together. And if you make me a nice box of lunch, maybe I'll be her.
How are we going, Curly, in that rigging makeup? All right, straddle the lots of rigging like lightning bugs.
That there ain't no made-up brick. I heard that one from Claremore myself.
Land, you did?
Sure did. Pretty one too. Hey, when I come call for you after supper, make sure you got your beauty spots fastened on tight so you don't lose them all. You hear me? The wheels are yellow, the upholstery is brown, the dashboard genuine leather. With icy glass curtains, you can roll right down in case there's a change in the weather. See us that on the way back to the station. Ain't no finer rig of a thinking that I'd be too small for that shiny little surrey with the fringe on the top.
Hey, Curly, make sure you tell all the girls in Bushyhead to stop by and freshen up. That means we'll have a lot of company. You better pack your lunch hamper.
And he's going to see more than Curly tonight. You do have to rent Jed all the boat.
That's the way you wanted it, ain't it?
No, I only did his clothes being so fresh to me earlier, but I'm afraid to tell John I won't go with him. Afraid to do something terrible. He makes me shiver every time I get close. I've been down to that old smokehouse where he's at.
Plenty of times. What?
You seen them pictures you got tacked on the wall?
Oh, yeah, I see them, but don't you pay no mind to
him. There's something wrong inside of his head, Aunt Heather. I know that I fasten my leaders and I lock my door to get in it, but I can always hear that. And footsteps from under the tree outside my room.
Laurie.
And at breakfast time, he comes out to get his food and looks at me from under those eyebrows or something to the brush or whatever. Well, I know what I'm talking about.
You crazy yogi! Stop acting like a chicken with your tail cut off. Now, who you reckon that is that just drove up? Why, it's that old beggar man. You know what he told me? He told me that Edgar beat up Eddie.
He said they know Eddie. Well, Parker's they know Eddie.
Oh, beggar man. He told me that if you ever beat up the eggs and turn off the dish rags and turn the ice cream freezer in, I don't know it all.
You don't know what you're doing.
Oh, beggar man. Hold your horses. I want to talk to you.
Hello, Aunt Ellie.
Hi, yourself.
Oh, Lord.
Hello. Well, Park's back in Kansas City. He's been looking for you.
Well, Parker. I expect on him being back so soon.
I can see. Can ride my piece?
The peddler man's gonna drive me to the box social. I'll get up sort of the tasty lunch.
Hey, Domain, have you talked about the peddler man?
Not yet.
Well, aren't you promising with Parker?
No, but you might say promise. I just told him, maybe.
Well, don't you like him a little more?
Of course I do. They want everything nobody like Will.
And what about the peddler man?
Well, they won't ever be nobody like him neither.
Well, which one do you like better?
Whatever one I'm with.
You are a silly.
Now, Lord, you know that if nobody paid in a lot up to the scene, and if I was scrawny and flat as a ankle, and then sort of running up a little, and now the boys act differently.
What's wrong with that?
Something's wrong. I like it. I like it so much when Bella talks pretty. I get all shaky from watching him. Don't you?
I can't think about what you're talking about.
Don't you feel sort of sorry for him?
What he looks like, he wants to kiss you.
But you can't just go around kissing every guy that asks you to. Ain't anybody ever tell you that?
Yeah, they told me.
You like so much a question of not knowing what to do. I know much better than I pretend. I hear a lot of stories and I crack one leg or two about how rude they're going to all the men. I know I mustn't fall into the pit, but when I'm with a feller, I forget! Just when I'm saying this, when a person tries to kiss a girl, I know she ought to give his face a smack. But as soon as someone kisses me, I somehow sort of want to kiss him back. I'm just a fool and life's hard though. I can't be prissy and quiet. When he is hanging up, for a while I treat
later.
Smile my Miss Glory. Could be crickets. That's gonna come through being just tiny like a shrimp. How did you? Great big beautiful lady.
Oh, that's your buddy. If you had breakfast this morning, go get yourself a green apple.
Alright, now Aunt Ella.
I ain't your Aunt Ella. Don't call me Aunt Ella, you whore. I'm mad at you.
Now don't you go and be mad. Can I say get you a present? Something to wear?
But stopping for to wear. Wouldn't have it. What is it?
Real silk. Made in poison.
What do I want with an old Persian barter? I'll try, Mom.
I don't hold out your foot.
Did you have any idea I was going to slide that garter on my limb? Grab onto my petticoats, Lori.
Funny woman. Pretty much was about to try to take your goddess off.
Yeah, because that would make your stockings fall down, wouldn't it? Now, give me the other one.
Which one? You want to buy, this one to match the other one?
What do you mean, do I want to buy it?
I can give it to you for, say, 40 cents bits.
You want me to bread the egg beater, ram it down your windpipe?
All right. Don't nobody want to buy something? How about you, Miss Glory? A young girl like yourself doesn't want something.
Me? Of course I want something. What a shiny silver buckle, the buckle my shoes are. Want to dress me in LA lace, want perfume, want to be pretty, want to smell like a honeysuckle vial.
Give her a cake of soap.
Ooh, one thing I've heard of never seen before. Want a little rubber tire buggy or glass head to your bowl. One thing I'm only to have is hold in your hands, but things happen to you, things I can't tell you about. Things so good that if they did happen to you, my heart just quit beating and you fall down dead.
You got just the thing. The elixir of Egypt.
What's that?
Snailing salts.
A special kind of smelling salts. Read what it says on the label. They got deep breath and see everything clean. That's what Pharaoh's body used to do. But if she had a heart to decide, like, you know, what prince she ought to marry or what dress to wear to a party, if, you know, she should cut someone's head off, she'd just take a nice deep breath of this.
Oh, I'll take it.
Precious stuff.
How much?
4 bits.
Throwing away your money.
I don't see the sign what to do.
Don't you want me to show you some pretty doodads with ribbons around the bottom and laces running in and out?
Well, there goes your suitcase, then. Yep. You need fancy drawers? Well, I would never wear those kind myself, but I sure do like to look at them.
Yeah, they could if you ain't going no place.
Bring your trappings inside and if I can find you something to eat and drink.
Last one, didn't you?
About what, baby?
About what you said about us traveling to the end of the world again.
Well, I didn't really mean to be ending.
Then, how far do you want to go?
As far as, say, Claymore, you know, the hotel.
Look at the hotel!
Front of the hotel is brand new. Inside, there's a lobby, and upstairs, well, upstairs might just be paradise.
I thought those were just bedrooms!
You and me, baby. Paradise.
You see? I knew I was right when we were drunk! You did love me, don't you?
Oh, hey there, lady. What did you just say?
I said you did want to marry me. Don't you want to say?
I did not say anything. Yoo-hoo, hey there, lady. I'm back! Angel Wendy, how's the husband? How's this little husband take out the sugar in the territory?
He really? This is Allie Hackham.
How are you, Hack? Don't mind the way I speak, it's alright, I'm going to marry her.
Marry her? Like, no, like this?
Well, of course.
This is
What will nothing? Know what I got for first prize at the fair? $50.
$50? Well, that's good.
Catch all your pa said I could marry you if I had $50.
That's probably good.
You know what I did with them $50? Spent them all on gifts for you. Well, the woman just told me to stop telling me it was worth more than the cash.
But, Will!
You can stop saying, but, Will, and just give me a little old kiss. Oh, wait, old Granny. I haven't stopped thinking about you since the time I left. All the time at fairgrounds, even, when I was chasing steers. I broke one from under the hoods and pulled them up sharp, and he ran with his little rump. And then I think of you.
Stop talking pretty, Will.
See a lot of beautiful girls in Kansas City. I didn't give one a look.
How did you see him if you didn't give him a look?
I mean, I didn't look loving at him like I look at you.
Stop looking at me like that, Will. I can't bear it.
Oh, stop looking like this, dude. Give me a little old kiss.
What's a little old kiss?
Nothing less than it comes from you.
No! I won't!
Suppose that I say I register like cherries or roses or berries. What's your prodigy? Dance to fill my heart, help but stay in an abundant, awaiting for something nice from you. I gotta get a kiss, and it's gotta be quick, or I'll jump in a crippling tie.
Please, my heart. Hey there, kiddo.
I'm sure sorry to see you so happy, just, but I gotta stay and keep you miserable. I gotta marry Will.
Well, that is sad, sad news for me.
Don't hurt your feelings, Allie. I can't bear it. I'd rather have you come right out and say our buster.
Okay, so you sure you gotta marry Will?
Sure, Sue.
And there was absolutely no chance of you ever possibly getting out of this, right?
No chance.
Okay then. My heart is busted in two.
Oh, Allie, you didn't make a perfect piece to say.
Is that you, Annie?
Hello, Paul. What you shooting?
Some rabbits. Not sure what I heard about Will Parker getting $50.
That's right. And he wants to hold you to your promise.
Too bad. Still, I can't go against my word.
See, Allie?
Now, I advise you get that money off him before he loses it. Put it in your corset, or you stock it, or you can't get to it. Or can it?
But, Paul, he ain't exactly kept it. He spends it all on presents.
See, what I tell you? I said it had to be $50 cash. Now we can't have you.
But, is that really fair?
What about you?
This is Allie Hackham!
Well, shut your trap or I'll fill your behind so full of buckshot, you'll be walking like a duck for the rest of your life.
Oh, Allie, if I don't have to marry Will, maybe your ride will have to be buzzed into like you said.
I didn't say that.
Yes, it.
No, you're not.
Are you making my daughter out to be a liar?
No, I'm just trying to make clear how much of a liar I am if she's telling the truth.
What else you say to my daughter?
Oh, an awful lot.
When?
Last night, in the moonlight.
Where?
Alongside a haystack.
Listen.
I'm listening. What type of stuff did you say to my daughter?
He called me his Persian king.
Why'd you call her that?
I don't remember.
I do. He called me his Persian kid. He was the captain. Stop routing!
Oh, at least part of that cared for that. I would be a marriage proposal.
Okay, now look, Mr. Kyle.
Oh, I'm looking.
I'm no good. I'm a peddler. A ped that travels up and down and all around. Look, you would hardly ever get to see a dog.
That'll be all right. You take care of her, Cindy. You take care of my little girl.
Yeah, you sure, Mr. Giles?
Oh, just you trying to change my mind.
Oh, Allie, ain't that wonderful? Mommy does not for us? He won't change me either. Once he gives you his word you can have me, well, you got me.
I know I've got you.
Mrs. Allie Hackland, the peddler of God, wait till I tell her.
I'm a happy man. I'm minding my own business like I oughta. Aping it anyhow to no one. Talking to a certain farmer's daughter. Then I'm looking at the muscle of a gun. It's getting so you can't have any fun. Every daughter has a father with a gun. It's a scandal, it's enough.
strange. How about your husband today?
If you make one mistake when the moon is bright, and I tie you to a contract, say you make it every night.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, when the bandits surround you and say, you gotta take and make an honest woman out of now.
So make you make her honest, she will lie like that.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, on a bandit it's a blow. Where is the leader who will say, mustn't be the first man to be shot?
Hey.
Yes, you! It's a scandal, it's an outrage, just a wait for in your groove.
You're less and less than a year by neck. There's a baby on his shoulder that you falls down your neck.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, any farmer will tell you it's true.
A rooster and a chicken is better off than better. He ate the special property of just one hat.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage, it was a problem we must solve. We got sort of revolution.
Oh,
heart to fame as much as I. Why do you take the trouble to pick my favorite pie? Granting your wish, I carve our initials on that tree. Just keep a slice of all the end my name so free. Don't praise my charm too much. Don't look so pale. Don't stand in the rain with me. People will say where in
Or a chair.
Then all you gotta do is take this here rope, tie it nice around your neck, and then fall off the log of the chair. In 5 minutes or less, the good luck is as a toenail.
And just what do you mean by that?
Then folks will come to your funeral and they sing sad songs.
Yeah.
It's true. You never know how many people laugh until you're dead.
Well, I suppose so.
Think about it. You'd be all laid out in the corridor. You'd back down in fast clothes, put your hair slicked back, and a high starch collar.
There'd be flowers in them.
Sure would. Palms too. All around your coffin. And the men would bare their heads, and the women would sniff softly. Somebody would flirt. The ones that took a shot to you would laugh.
Oh, what woman ever took a shot at me?
Plenty of women. They just wouldn't come out and say it. Unless you're not first.
Well, I guess.
It sure seemed that, too. It seemed like your heart's afraid.
Poor John is dead. Poor John cries.
Maybe you'll go first.
Maybe. Now, where'd you say you worked at before you came down here? It was up at Kapal, wasn't it?
Yeah, up at Kapal. Before that, about Tulsa. Folks hated me there, treated me like dirt, both places.
So what'd you do to get even?
Get even? Who said anything about getting even?
No one that I recollect. Just came to my head.
Whoever wants to get even, I know how to do it.
With that?
Oh, well, no. There's a lot of ways to do it than this. You gotta use your brain things and that sort of thing. Did you hear the fire up at the ball at that farm?
Sure did. Terrible accident. About 5 years ago. Burned the mother, father, the daughter.
See, about that. Fella told me that that wasn't an accident.
Wait, so it was him that burned the place?
Yeah, the farmhand. Rumor has it he was separate with the farmer's daughter, and then eventually he came back one night and found her in a hayloft with another fella.
Probably murdered too, huh? Hey, why don't you get some air here?
You still haven't told me what your business here is, Curly. You ain't got no. You got the cattle or cow points the little cross done spoke for.
Oh, you sure believe my mind, consider it.
There's only one thing that you could be wanting on this farm, and it better not be that.
But that's just what it is.
Better not be.
Somebody better tell over the man you truly are. For that matter, somebody will tell you once yourself.
You best be getting out of here, Curly.
A man wouldn't feel very comfortable in here with you, Judd, unless they didn't know you. But I know you, Judd. In this country, there's two things a man can do. Live outdoors as one, and live in a home as the other. As long as you live in a hole you're scared, or you can have muscles, like arm, and still be as weak as an inch as that. Where did you get to be the way you are here today? Watch for some help at once. Stay in here. Crawl in the bed. Get off!
You want to do a bit now? Put an arm in the roof, though.
I'm just sure to let me show you something. You see that knob over there, big and down? You see the wing?
Yeah, sure I did.
Bullet right through the knot hole, that touch you! Slick as a whistle, I knew I could do it. You saw it too, didn't you?
I specialized them.
Who fired a gun? Who fired a gun? Curly, was that you? Don't say to you on the answer you spoke to.
I shot once.
Well, what was you shooting at?
You see that knot hole there?
I see lots of knot holes.
Well, there's one of them.
Well, ain't you a pair of pretty cousins picking away at knot holes and scaring everybody to death? I already gave you a good dutch rubbing her from the craziness at you. It's all right, no one ever heard just a pair of fools talking noises.
Hope you don't mind about this with you gents. Oh, it's good to get away from the room for a while. But now that we're all by our own, so we have a few private knickknacks to show you, especially from the
dental. I'll see you gentlemen later. Got a good story after tonight.
And just who you think you're driving in that story?
Aunt Ellie, maybe Lord. She'll come with me.
She won't.
Maybe she will.
No, she promised that she'd go with me.
Hot postcards.
Just hire them off on those. You got any frost stickers, though?
I know, one of the long knives?
Yeah, one of the knives. Anything that can kill a hog or a skunk, really. Actually, you know what I like a lot better than a crawl sticker? Ever heard of a little woman? Yeah, you see, it's something that you got to look into. And it turns on one side, and it shows you all these pictures. Except there's a jigger on the one end that if you knock out of the way just right, it springs out a sharp blade and run it.
On like a spring, right?
Yeah, on a spring. What you do, you go up to a fella and you go, hey, take a look at this. And as it's turning through, eventually, comes undone, spring comes out, and well, that goes.
Yeah, good practical joke to play on a friend. I don't handle things quite like that. It's a little too dangerous for my taste, but what I would like to show you, a new stock of our postcards.
God, I'm tired of these pictures of women. I'll give you a new one.
Well, what the heck was wrong with a real one? I'm having trouble right now. I'm counting.
and he's telling you you want her. Look at you. Your man's free to come and go as he pleases. Cozy little place to live.
Private, not much to bother you. Artistic pictures. They don't talk back to you.
Look, Heather, man, I know what I said and I made up my mind. But if you're a real woman.
Alright, so you tell me you want a real woman. You wouldn't happen to know a girl by the name of Ada Wang, would you?
Please, I don't want her.
I don't want her either, but I got her.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
could eat a gatepost.
Let one of the men be the auctioneer. No.
All right then. Now you know the rules, gentlemen. You gotta be blind. You ain't supposed to know a girl goes with blood hamper. Of course, if your sweetheart has told you that hers will be done in a certain color ribbon, that ain't my fault. Now, we'll start at the other side of the house, then there, and we'll make our way back here. Follow me! Woo!
And this antebellum,
yes,
what the hell you do?
Yes.
Would you spend every cent you had on her? That's what I did. See that bag full of presents? $50, all I had in the world.
So, if you had $50,
I'd have 808 and you'd lose her.
Yeah. I'd lose her. Let's see what you got that bag. I want to buy something?
What would you want with them?
Well, apparently, like, buying a cell, maybe pay you some real money, maybe as much as, you know, a lot. My, what a beautiful hot water bag. Well, it's French. Must have cost plenty. I gave you $8 for it.
$8? Well, that wouldn't be fair. I only spent $3.50.
So I give you $8, and I will. Hey, now, that's a cracker.
Take your hands off that. That was for our wedding night.
Don't fit me too good. I'll give you $22 for it.
But that's
all right, fine. $22.50. And a cent more.
There, those, that was for her to wear,
Then I'll think it was for you. Mighty Dancing, I give you, say, $15 for it. Okay, so, $22 plus 8, that's 30, and 15, that's 45, and 50 cents, that's 45.50.
45.50? Say, that's almost. What about some more?
Mike?
Did you ever see one of these?
What made you buy this? Add it to somebody?
What do you mean? It's just funny pictures.
Where's everybody? Where's Aunt
Ellen? On the other side of the house, Lori.
Alright. Where'd you run off to?
I don't like to handle things like this. A little too dangerous for me.
What do you mean? It's just a girl in pink ties.
I don't even think it is. It's more than that.
Either you can see Lori.
On the other side of the house. The auction's going on there.
Right. Oh, Judge. Here's one of them things you said for the little one then.
How much?
$3.50.
$3.50. Money, but I got an idea. Might be worth it.
Say $3.50 from you and $45.50 from you. That ought to give me $50, eh?
Nope. $1 short.
All right, I must have figured wrong. How much would you give for all the rest of the stuff in the bag?
$1.
Done. Now I got $50, eh, man? And that means I get 8 already.
Well, you wouldn't put my dad's me now, would you?
And when her father figures out who I got most of the money off of, maybe he'll reconsider who's smart and who's dumb.
Say, young fellow, certainly bunkled me.
Everybody, grab a seat where you like. Now, here are the last few hampers. Who they are, I ain't got no idea.
Oh, the big one's mine. The little one's Lori's.
Well, that's in a dive secret. Now, what fix this.
Oh, nah. Oh, come on. Six bits.
Six bits ain't enough for a lunch like Ada Wayne can make. Let's hear a dollar. What about you, Mike? You won for last year.
Hey,
Ada
Wayne,
our
same
sugar
pie like you had last year?
You bet! Same old sweet for tater pie, Mike. What do you say?
You mean 3AW.
Never mind about that. Who bit the dollar?
Damn, last slice of cake out of 6 bits.
Eat a dollar.
90 cents.
90 cents? We're getting rich. Another desk in the schoolhouse. You want to get more?
You hear $50.
$50? Why, nobody ever gets $50 for a lunch. Nobody ever gets 10.
He ain't got $50.
Oh, yes, I do. And if you're a man of honor, you gotta say, I'll get 8 like you said you would.
Well, where's your money?
Oh. Right here in my hands.
That ain't yours. You just did, didn't you? I gotta say, the peddler still wins my daughter's hand.
Now, that ain't fair.
Go in for $50! Go in!
51!
Are you crazy? 55! Wait a minute. If I don't get my money, I can keep it, can't I?
Sure can.
And then I still got $50. This is mine!
You feeble-minded sheep poke.
Going on for $51. And Dana Wayne will get the prize again.
And I get Dana Wayne.
Woo! What are you getting for your $51?
Yeah, Billy.
Now, here's my niece's hamper. I took a peek inside and I must say it looks mighty tasty. What do I hear, Jess?
2 bits.
4 bits.
What do you say, Oxys?
$1.
More now, can do I hear two?
$1.25.
$2.
$2.50.
$2.75.
$3.
$3.02.
$3.04.
$4.
$4.02.
4 1/4. I got 4 1/4 from Judge Rod. You gonna let him have it?
4 1/2.
Go in for 4 1/2.
$4.75.
$4.75. Come on, gentlemen. Schoolhouse ain't built yet. Gotta get an opportunity.
$5.
Go in for $5.
$5.02.
Ain't got nearly enough yet. Not for a cold up of stuff and then that lemon meringue pie.
$6.
Going for $6. Going for $6.
$6.02.
My, you're stubborn, Judd. And Mr. Carnes is a richer man than you. And I know he likes his custard with raspberry syrup. Anybody get a bid anymore?
Nah, I don't think so. They all dropped out, can't you see? Now, here's the money.
Now hold on, you. I ain't said going gone yet.
We'll say it.
Somebody.
I got 10.
You got cash?
Right in my pocket.
Now let's not waste any time. How high you going?
Well, higher than you no matter what.
And Ellen, I'm bidding this $10 for your skating.
Going for $10. Going for $10. Going.
$10 and 2 bits.
Early.
Hope she boys know my horse, Jenna. She's a very nice horse. Chance on well, girl.
I'll give you
$25 for it. I'll sell Jensen. That makes my bid $35, Aunt Ellen.
Curly, you're crazy. But it's all for the schoolhouse, ain't it? All for educating and learning. Going for $35! Going for $35!
Hold on now, I ain't finished bidding. You just put everything you got in the world, didn't you? Can't beat your clothes. Ain't worth nothing. Can't
Take your gummies and eat that. Yes, sir, you need that bad. So, Annabella, I figure I'm about as reckless as Curly McLean here. I'm just as good at getting what I want. So I'm gonna do the unthinkable. I'm gonna put everything I've got, too. Everything I've saved up for 2 years doing hard farm labor for you. Here it is! $47.32 exactly! Anybody wanna buy a better car?
You quit? You brought a brand new last Thanksgiving. Worth a lot.
Curly Wilson, you're for a fix. You make $2 for it.
That makes my bid $53, Anna. Anybody going any higher?
Going, going on! Listen, Anna, with you folks. Ain't nobody gonna cheer or nothing?
That's the idea, ain't it? The cowman and the farmer should be friends. You lost the bid, but the bid was fair. Come on, cowman, shake the farmer's hand.
God, what the heck? You know how I feel, this girl.
That's better.
See, Curly, I'd like to show you something. Excuse me, sorry. You ever see one of these? What is it? Ah, don't worry about that. All you gotta do is just put your eye up to this here.
Hey, Curly! What are you doing?
Doing? Nothing much. What are you trying to scare a man like that? Scare the liver and locks out of his belly.
Well, then stop looking at those old Frank pictures and ask me for a dance. You brought me to this party for a reason, didn't you?
All right, you crazy old woman. You want to dance? I'll dance home with the middle if you want.
Take that bag to pieces.
Well, you know, Annie, now that I got $50, you just need to pick a date.
August 15th.
What, August 15th?
That was the first day I was kissed.
Was it? I don't remember that.
You wasn't there.
Now, listen to me, 808. Now that we're engaged, you need to stop fooling around. I mean, with other feathers. You'll have to be a little more standoffish when fellas offer you a buggy ride.
I'll be lying, let's be seen of a crawfish and take myself a whole ride to the hole.
I heard how you was picking up some papers when I was off in Kansas City
Mall.
I heard some things you couldn't risk in papers from fellers who've been talking like they know.
But I only did the kind of things I were sort of to you. As people as can be, hurry, and story about the way I got my bloopers.
What?
Bloopers! A lot of things in a lot of me.
The whole thing don't sound very good to me.
Well, you see,
I go and sold my last wallet, oh, I cut out all shenanigans. I save my money, don't gamble, don't drink in the bathroom down at Brannigan's. I give up lots of other things a gentleman never mentions. But before I give up anymore, I want to know your intentions. With me, it's all or nothing. Is it all or nothing with you? It can't be in between. It can't be now and then. No half and half romance will do. I hope a woman, man, hold on the tight. Oh, complete with slippers and tight. Take me like I am, or leave me be. If you can't give me all, give me nothing. And nothing's what you'll get from me. Nothing's what you'll get from me.
Better
look alive.
Already, she's gone then.
But won't she do something to me? I gotta find someone to see me.
must turn around and look, crazy woman.
Early!
Well, you found yours, so I gotta go hunt for mine.
Now we'll go to sell the claymore by coming to you later.
Early, I'm afraid to pay for my life. Don't you leave me.
Great God, Mother.
Don't let me cry.
Cry, Rosa.
I don't know what to do.
Here, I'll show you. Oh my goodness! That's about all Ned Sam put. Get away from me, you!
Really, you don't like me no more?
Lord, look here. Tell you what. You stand over there, and I'll stand over here. You tell me what you really want.
Well, Chubb's here. He scared me. He's more out than I've ever seen anybody talk so crazy. And he threatened me, so I fired him. I wish I had it. There ain't no telling what he'll do now.
You fired him? Well, then that's all there is to it. Tomorrow morning I'll get you a new hired hand. I'll stay on the farm myself tonight. If you're worried about that hound dog, now put your word. While we're at it, how about you marry me?
Gracious, what do I want to marry you for?
I don't know. Maybe you can think of the reason why you're mad.
Well, I can hardly think of nothing right now.
Lord, please, man, marry me. I don't know what I would do with you.
Honey, I'll marry you. You want me to?
I'll be the happiest man who's married. I know I gotta start learning how to come forward. Quit throwing the rope and start blistering my hands a new way. Because of the changing, I gotta change with bring up a new pair of gloves. You stopped to put this crazy in your country. But now I got you to do it. Well, I'm that self too. I remember when I first saw you, it was at the fair. We were riding that great filly, the Blue Stars. I remember asking someone. He was asking a little thing with a bad name for a forehead.
I remember he was riding bronchos that day.
Sure was.
And one of them throwed you.
Did not throw me.
Guess he jumped off.
Sure did. If anyone out there can hear my voice, I want you to know that Laura Williams is my girl.
Girlie!
And she has been married.
They'll hear you all the way to Susie.
Let her.
My people say that in love there's what love's not.
Just keep your heads in line. Your hand is a wedding
line. My people say.
Goodbye,
lady. You promise you won't think of that old peddler man anymore?
Never think of no one.
then I'm never gonna leave your side.
Even if you don't, even if you never go on another trip or nothing, can't you, once in a while, be one of those Persian goodbyes?
Persian goodbyes? Well, they ain't nothing like an Oklahoma hello.
Hello!
Downstairs.
Yeah!
where's good old-fashioned tradition? You women just stay out of the way.
Vamoose, I've got about it.
You gotta be hardy. You gotta be. Days won't wait, though. You can't deserve the sweet and tender in life unless you're tough.
I wish I was like you.
They all say it's crying old. You better hire me to be the way I am.
What I do without you, you said you can't. Shut your mom.
They're taking Jill over to Doc Tyler's this morning.
Is he alive?
Lord, honey, Corey allowed me and Federal Marshal. He said I ought to give myself up tonight.
Tonight? Well, I've been training these Claremonts just 20 minutes.
Best thing for Curly to do is to go to his own court. Tell the judge.
Why, you're the judge anyway, Andrew?
Yes, but...
Well, tell him now and give up for it.
Wouldn't be proper. We have to do it in court.
Well, let's just do it here and say we did it in court. Come on, Andrew.
You can't do that. That'd be breaking the law.
Well, let's not break the law, then let's just bend it a little. Come on, Andrew, start the trial. We ain't got but a few minutes.
Andrew, I got a
problem. Oh, shit, you're a trap. We can give that boy a fair trial without locking him up on his wedding night.
Yeah!
Now, here's the long and short of it. What's your plea? It means why you do it. Why? You've been pissing Lord for so long. I was told him I would.
Do on your tongue while brining your mouth like that. Now tell me, what happened now that you killed me?
Why, he came at me with a knife.
And you had the vineyards though, right?
Why, yes, furthermore.
There's no furthermore. The police self-defense!
Quiet!
Now, is there any witnesses?
Andrew, I got a funny feeling about this.
Don't talk that funny when I told you I'm carrying on to other women.
I won't carry it on. No.
Hey, who's gonna feel better when I tell you what you are?
All right, laugh all you like. That's Federal Marshal.
Oh, shut up about being a Federal Marshal. We ain't gonna let you take this boy to jail on his wedding night. We ain't gonna let you, so shut up.
Hey, come on, fellas.
Let's
go to the training,
Curly,
Surrey, and we'll be the
horses. No, I ain't even said the verdict yet.
Well, it's not guilty, eh? No, but...
Well, they say it.
Not guilty!
Misunderstanding, but
So my name's Lamont. I'm a senior at I just want, before everyone leaves, just want to share like a little bit of my experience, because this is my last time being on the stage, my last bow. I've been in HTG for 5 years. In 8th grade, I got the opportunity to come to the high school and participate in Bye Bye Birdie, which was a great show, and then I did Grease, and then we did Into the Woods, and unfortunately, on opening night of Into the Woods, COVID happened, and the show closed, which was really unfortunate. I know a lot of the people in this cast were supposed to be in Into the Woods. And then The Little Mermaid, now this show, I've done a lot of shows here, and I can't explain the friends and family that I've made in this cast. It's honestly like crazy. The directors, the choreographers, the music directors, stage crew, orchestra, they put together such an amazing show, and I'm so glad that all of you guys came to experience it. So I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you so much for coming to the show tonight.
I know you guys want to leave this long show, which is like 1 more minute. So today, this show is an extra special show because usually every year we only have one new class come to the HTG to perform for the first time on the stage. But this year is extra special because not only are the freshmen brand new, but so are the sophomores and the juniors, because they never got a chance to perform on this stage. So I just wanted to say I'm so proud of every single one of you. You guys did so good. And we wouldn't have been able to do it without Dr. Riso, Dr. DeVivo, Ms. O'Hara, and Ms. Roberts. It is also those directors, it's their first year here as well. So the HTG is starting with a brand new group of people, and we're really excited to be here. We also want to say thank you to Ms. Campuzano and Mr. Mester. And lastly, I just want to say congratulations to all the seniors, like Mom was saying. They just worked so hard, and I'm so, so beyond happy that they got a chance to perform on this stage, because so many seniors before didn't get a chance to because of COVID. So I'm just so happy to see them all and share the stage with them, and we're all going to miss them a lot next year. So.